Hi guys, so today I thought I would do something a little bit different from the standard look at what I eat in a day or this is how I work out. So if you have watched my previous videos or if you've been reading the blogs up on the Protein King website, you will know that I am beyond 100% obsessed with Quest bars. So today I thought I would show you two of my favorite recipes. I wish I could say that I made them up by myself, but unfortunately I'm not that creative. So these are just two recipes that I found online that are a little bit different to, or a nice alternative to just eating a Quest bar as it is. Yeah, so the two recipes, the one, they call it like a cheesecake bite, but it's not really cheesecake, it's just like Quest and yogurt. And the other one is just a little alternative, so instead of putting it in the microwave, I'm just going to bake it, but I'm going to show you guys how I would do it and then kind of like further that recipe as well. So the two flavors that I have today, I've got the cookies and cream and the cinnamon roll. Cinnamon roll I got just because the cheesecake bites, I reckon I kind of felt like they would probably taste better with a cinnamon roll because that would be more, I don't know, like cheesecakey. And then I got the cookies and cream one because let's be honest, all the other flavors were sold out. Anyway, back to it. I've got my oven on at the moment, just on bake and heating up to 180 degrees. So getting to the recipes, I'm just gonna show you guys what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna use the cookies and cream bar first. So usually I would just use baking paper, but because I've done this so many times over the last couple of days, I finished it all. So I'm just using normal foil, and I've cut them up into little tiny baby pieces, but you guys can kind of cut them up however you want. I do recommend smaller pieces because then in my mind that means that there's more to eat. So I've cut that up. I'm just waiting for the oven to heat up, and then I'm just going to pop them in there for 5 to 6 minutes. So that was my bad, I forgot to hit record and just did everything and it didn't record. So with these ones, these are like the little cheesecake bites. I feel so stupid now. Okay, so basically what I did, I took the cinnamon roll Quest bar, cut it in half and then microwaved it for literally like 7 seconds just to soften it up. You don't want it to start like expanding like a cookie. You just want it to be a bit soft so it's easy to push into the mold. So I don't actually know what happened to my cupcake mold. I used to have a really like proper one. So all I have was these like little silicone ones. So took it out the microwave and then with this one, I kind of like flattened it with my hand and then pushed it into the mold. And then with this one, I just kind of took half of it and pushed it in and then did it. So I'm not actually 100% sure which one worked better. I forgot about the cookies and cream. I'm a terrible baker. So anyway, yeah, so I pushed them into the mold, so that's kind of what they look like now. And then as soon as the like cookies and cream bites come out of the oven, I'm gonna pop these in and let them bake for also about 5 to 6 minutes. Just watch them because you don't want them to burn, obviously. So, ooh, that's hot. So I've just taken the cookies and cream ones out of the oven and they haven't really expanded that much. I don't know if you guys can see them. They've just obviously gone really soft as they would when they get hot. So I'm just gonna leave those, just make sure that like they're not stuck to the foil. So I'm just gonna leave these for like 5 to 10 minutes, just let them cool down. Try not to eat them because that defeats the purpose. But yeah, just gonna leave them for a little while, let them cool a bit, and I'll show you guys what I'm gonna do with them. Should probably check on those. It smells so good. Okay, so they're just about ready. They've got like really, really soft now. Just watch them. They're starting to get a little bit, not burnt, but like you can see that they're gonna be really crispy on the outside. So just watch them. Don't leave them alone. Don't forget about them because I guarantee you will regret it. So I'm just gonna go get them. So I've just taken them out of the oven. This is what they look like now. You can see they're just a little bit burnt, but they've kind of made like a nice little cup. So So again, just leave those to cool for like maybe 10 minutes. You want them to go, but you want them to get crunchy. You don't want them to be too soggy. I just had like a little brainwave. I'm just gonna put these in the fridge. Never done it before, don't burn me, bye. So I have just checked on the cookies and cream bites and they are perfect. They're the same size as they were when I cut them up, but they've hardened up nicely. So you can either eat them just as they are, just show you guys what they look like. You can either eat them as they are. I have another one, which the macros for that would be 7 grams of fat, 22 grams of carbs, of which 17 is fiber, and 21 grams of protein. So as is, those are the macros. Or you can do what I'm gonna do, and I'm gonna go out and buy some unsweetened vanilla almond milk and eat it like a breakfast cereal. Hashtag wife me, hashtag MasterChef material. So yeah, if your macros allow it, you can always do 2 Quest bars instead of one. Obviously that would be a very large meal macro-wise, but it's a nice little alternative to normal cereal. Obviously there's, if you did two, there would be a total of 2 grams of sugar. And if you did one, there's 1 gram of sugar. Hashtag math. So nice, great alternative to sugary, unhealthy breakfast cereal right there. So excited. So I've taken these little bites, cupcakes, whatever you want to call them, out of the fridge. So they've kind of ended up looking like that. There's a nice little crust on them. I'm hoping they don't break. That is now what they look like. They formed like great little cupcake molds. I'll show you what I'm doing now. Be patient. Okay, so now that that's done, I'm just gonna pop in some 0% fat Greek yogurt. I suppose if you wanted, you could also like mix up some cream cheese or cottage cheese or peanut butter. I'm just gonna measure mine out. Just because macros. So I just filled that up with some Greek yogurt and then sprinkled some cinnamon on top. I am so excited, like you guys actually have no idea. Awesome, so let me know what you guys think. Try it out if you guys have any tweaks to the recipe and wanna let me know. Comment below. Like I said, you know, you can add pretty much whatever you want. You can add some PB2, you can add some fruit, some chocolate if you want to be a bit naughty. But yeah, I just used Greek yogurt and cinnamon because macros, but I am so excited. Thanks for watching, guys. If you want to see any more recipes, let me know and I will try and cook up something incredible for you guys. But until next time, bye.